Welcome to Javi's Cooking Theory, a show in which the chef has no cooking experience, but don't worry, I have an apron. Today, we're making scrimp burritos.
So in the shrimp burritos, we're going to be having shrimp, we're going to have cheese, some sour cream, some pico with corn, some red cabbage slaw, and some salsa verde that I make myself. In order to get all this done, we're going to need some tortillas, some cheese, some cilantro, we're going to need some red onions, jalapenos, red cabbage, tomatillos, limes, avocados, tomatoes, that shrimp, now again, sour cream, mayo, and these are the spices that I use, but of course you can use whatever you want depending on the flavor profile you're going for. So we're going to start off by adding some salt and pepper to some of the veggies that we cut. We covered in olive oil so that way they would stick, and we're going to roast them in the oven at 425 degrees. Depending on your oven, you may want to change the temperature that it's at, but this is what I've noticed works pretty well in my oven. Everything said, I don't have any cooking experience, so you know, I could be wrong, so of course, do what you think's necessary. Now, I'm going to cut up the rest of the half of the onion that I have, just so that way I can start getting ready on that pico. So we cut that up, throw it into a container. This is what I like to do. I notice that my red onions don't split a bunch, so I put them into this and then I shake it up. Usually helps break it down so they're smaller pieces. Now we're going to do the same thing. The tomato, cut that up. I'm not good at it, so I had to speed it up because I take forever. And then once we're done, grab all that and put it into the container as well. We're going to want to check on those veggies that are in the oven since it gets pretty hot. About halfway through, I like to flip them over, make sure that we get them cooked nice and well on all the sides, get them nice and roasted. Tomatillos could get soft, so be careful with those. If you clamp down too hard, they may squish, so just be careful. Now, I decided to go a little rogue, add some corn into my pico. You can do the same if you want, but you're definitely going to have to add in the cilantro into the pico to make it legit. I just did a rough chop to start, and then after I do this for a little bit, I do a finer chop just to get it nice and small. There we go. Put it into the pico. And then the last thing that we're going to need for that pico is just adding in some lime. And we're going to roll it out so that way we can get it nice and juicy. When I'm looking for these limes, I'm looking for ones that are nice and soft when I squeeze them. So we're going to do that, get all the juice out of it, add some salt, add some pepper, and then lastly add in a little bit of cumin just to give it a little kick. Now, go check on those veggies again. They seem to be nice and ready, so take them out and I'm just going to let them cool on the side. I'm going to start getting ready for the red cabbage slaw, so I'm going to cut it into fairly thin slices. And then I'm going to add some mayo, some salt, of course, pepper, and then lastly, just adding in some lime. I've never made a red cabbage slaw, so this could be very wrong, but we'll see. Like I said, no professional experience. Now, for the shrimp, I like to add some mayo and all the seasons that I listed earlier. I like to add in cayenne and paprika to give it some kick. If you don't like it spicy, you can try growing up and not being a little baby. But yeah, this is the spices I use. Use what you want. This is just what I go with. I saw somebody use mayo before, and it works as a good binder, and later on, you don't even have to use oil when you're cooking. So now that all the veggies are cooled off, I'm going to put them into a blending cup, so that way I can make our salsa verde, get some of the avocado, and then just push it in there. Mine was getting pretty full, so just had to manhandle it for a moment. Add some lime, add some garlic powder, add some extra virgin olive oil, and then blend it together. Alright, so I like to put my cheese in the freezer for a couple minutes before I grate it, just so that way it's a little bit harder. A lot of times when I'm grating, if it's too soft, it'll like kind of slide and it'll start like mushing, so I like to get it a little frozen, like a little more solid, so that way I can grate it a bit easier. Just put those cheeses together and then wait. Of course, gotta give the dog the cheese stacks. Cute little dog, she deserves it. So now we're gonna cook the shrimp after it marinated for a while. So just put it into a hot pan. Like I said, you don't need to add oil due to the fact that the mayo already has oil. So nice and easy. I noticed that I've had way too much in it though, so I poured some out and then just cooked it lightly. Make sure you don't overcook it because then it'll get hard and almost rubber-like. Now to actually build out the burritos, I put it on a little griddle so we could get it nice and hot. Put some cheese on top so that way it would melt some. And then transfer it over to the burrito building station, add my shrimp, add my pico on top, red cabbage slaw, some of the salsa verde, and some sour cream. I never worked at Chipotle, so I never learned how to roll properly, but damn, I did good.
Now for the taste. God damn, actually. This is the best one yet. Wow. We really did it. I hope we're eating.